In this video, we're going to talk a little more about those mystical Web IDs that we see keep popping up in our URLs. We're going to go over the basics of what a Web ID is, why they're important, and how to distinguish between the different versions of Web IDs. In a later video, we'll describe the more advanced process of how to build Web IDs from scratch. Web IDs are unique identifiers that are hashes of both the path and one or more GUIDs for the object being queried. The reason we use both GUIDs and paths is to make the Web IDs resilient to changes in the name or the GUID, so your client application can cache these persistent, fully defined Web IDs rather than having to make multiple round trips to find any of them out when querying, if you know you'll be querying the same object multiple times. Version 1 Web IDs are opaque, which is to say that there is no publicly exposed way to back-translate these Web IDs into their corresponding paths and GUIDs. Version 2 Web IDs have publicly exposed specification to build them, which we'll talk about in a separate video. There are two versions of Pi Web API Web IDs. The two versions are easily distinguished between. Version 1 has the second character of the Web ID as a 0, and version 2 has the second character of the Web ID as a 1. Version 2 Web IDs are the default ones returned by Pi Web API version 2017 R2 and later. Version 1 is returned in all versions prior to 2017 R2. An important note is that newer versions of the Pi Web API are also capable of translating version 1 Web IDs and able to properly respond. However, the reverse is not true. Pi Web API versions prior to 2017 R2 aren't capable of recognizing and responding to version 2 Web IDs. For many developers, this is a sufficient basis for understanding Web IDs in the Pi Web API. If you are interested in learning how to create and translate Web IDs, please see the second video on translating Web ID version 2.0.